When I was young, it was every kid's dream to go to Disneyland. The advertisement raged on constantly between Saturday morning cartoons. And the summer holidays were coming up. So, you know every kid was asking their parents to take them. And you know I was one of them. My parents always kept quiet about it, never giving a straight answer. I was close to giving up on the dream of going to the Magic Kingdom. Until they pulled me aside before the end of the school term. "Adam," they said, "we've been hearing great things from your teachers this year, and your grades have improved so much. We're very proud of you. So we saved some money aside, and we're taking you to Disneyland." How should a kid react? And thank their parents politely and profusely? Express their love joyously? Well, being 8, and having a low emotional constitution, I simply broke down and cried. It was the happiest moment ever that I can remember. And will probably never be topped. How can you ever top such wholehearted, innocent childhood glee? The time just slipped by until we were on the plane to Paris. Life was a happy blur until the vivid memory of the magnificent entrance to the park. It was everything a kid could wish for. I tried my best to do everything. Honestly, the energy kids have is astounding. Looking back, my parents must have been heavily exhausted trying to keep up. Yet they never faltered, knowing it was bringing me lasting joy. And for that, I'm grateful. However, it had cost them a pretty penny for the whole trip. And one memory stands out to me, which is the reason I'm writing this. We were at the gift shop, and they were picking up various merchandise and suggesting we buy it as a souvenir. Everything they picked up were simple little trinkets, little keychains, fridge magnets, and other little pieces. I wasn't having any of it. It wasn't enough to encapsulate my feelings for the trip. I kept going back to an intricate glass figure of a beautiful Disney character. I can't even say which one, it's been so long. And there's a more detailed part of this story that is more ingrained in my memory. The figure cost around 120 euros, which was a lot for the time. Way too much for my parents. They obviously said no every time. And this next part saddens me. I became irritated. I was one of those kids, kicking and screaming and pointing at the thing I wanted, being very loud and obnoxious. I still remember the embarrassed look on their face. We left without buying anything, and I was left with no souvenir. Or so they thought. What they didn't know is later that day I went back into the shop. I was 8, so I was small enough to duck behind shelves without looking too suspicious. I reached over to the figurine and hid it in my Mickey Mouse hat. I looked over to the shopkeeper. He was busy with the customer. The other customers didn't notice. I thought I'd got away with it. Until I noticed, far out of the door, there was a mascot facing my direction. At first, I thought he saw me, but in my mind, I figured he couldn't have. I reasoned that the visibility in those things were terrible, and that he was probably just facing the store because he was trying to attract new customers in, and thanking customers who left. When I walked past, he simply turned his head as I made my way back to my parents. He made no attempts to confront me. Past then, the memory fades. I simply went back to being a kid in school, sharing memories with other kids who managed to go for the holidays, and scoffing at the kids who never managed to go. It's an amusing concept looking back, but it created an almost serious dichotomy back in the day. It wasn't until a few weeks later that I started seeing some weird things happen. It was small at first. I would be playing in the schoolyard, and from behind a tree off in the distance, I would see what I thought was a thin black arm with a novelty-sized white glove slipped behind it. A strange sight to see. However, there were white pigeons in the area, and it was dark in that part of the woods, so it was easy to explain away. And this continued from then on. Each time I would rationalize it in my head. However, it didn't take long until it was getting harder to do so. Sometimes I would see the top of two black domes hiding behind a wall before slipping down out of sight. I would peek over to see what it was again and see nothing, with nowhere anything could hide. I tried being faster, however, I could never catch a full glimpse of the thing. There was one thing I could piece together though, based on all of the parts I'd seen hiding. It was definitely a Mickey Mouse mascot. The one instance that really scared me so much, I started screaming, was the night when I was tucked in bed. I turned my head nonchalantly through my window. I could see the iconic Mickey Mouse ears and the top half of its eyes. This was the most I'd ever seen of its face, and I instantly panicked. I did everything under a kid's arsenal to get help. I ran around, I screamed, I cried, I made as much noise as possible. In record time, my parents ran in and they tried to calm me down. They kept asking me what happened, and all I could do was point at the window and garble out a mess of sounds. We all turned to the window and saw nothing. From then on, I was actively scared of anything Disney. Other kids would have their Disney toys and I would shy away. They would bring up the Disney movies they saw that night before, and I would try and turn the conversation onto another topic. I got rid of anything I had that was remotely Disney. Anything to ease my mind and erase the trauma that I had experienced. It never worked, but it helped. After that, things calmed down. I feel I would be close to seeing something disturbing, but it'd be out of sight as soon as my eyes focused. Still though, it never eased the paranoia. Something that haunted my every day. I felt I was close to forgetting all of this and living with the residing feelings after that traumatic event. Until in high school, when my best friend's birthday was coming up. Disney was still a popular topic, despite us having grown up since the hype. He decided to organise a Disney trip and bring two friends. One of those kids that had parents who could afford to do such a grand gesture. I tried to deny the invitation, but he was my best friend and wouldn't take no for an answer. I tried getting my parents to pull me out, but they thought I was just nervous about the flight. So it wasn't long until I was boarding a flight to my literal nightmare. The group consisted of my best friend, one of his friends, his parents, and me. As soon as we were settled in, we were off to have our grand adventure. It didn't take long until we split up to do our own things for a bit, with a time and place to meet up afterwards. I strolled around the park trying to mind my own business and avoid the mascots. It hadn't been so long that I was ready to let down my guard in front of them, despite the friendly setting. It was odd, but every time I walked past a mascot, I swear they would briefly drop what they were doing, whether they were promoting merchandise or talking to a kid, and just stare at me as I passed. They just turn their heads slowly, their novelty-sized eyes glaring at me, cold and dead. At night, I tried to feel safe. I locked my door, tucked under my blankets, and tried to sleep the night away. However, I couldn't. The light seeping in through my open curtain perturbed me and briefly reminded me of that night so long ago. I figured it couldn't happen again if I fully shut my curtains. So I went over to do so. As I grabbed each side to draw them shut, I noticed something in the distance. Standing in the middle of the grounds, completely in the open, was a mascot. It was Mickey, just standing there. If it wasn't so far away, I could have sworn it was looking in my window. I stared at it for a bit. It was just glaring, unmoving, disturbing. My heart started to race. I was too scared to look away. But eventually, I developed a resolve and pulled the curtain shut as hard as I could. I raced to my bed and wrapped myself up so tight that any childish fears couldn't penetrate. And I slept to the gentle sound of something soft brushing my window. And what I feared now was heavy breathing. In the morning, I woke up exhausted. My friends, on the other hand, were sprightly awake and ready for a day of action. Obviously, I tried bringing up the night before, but you can never fully convey anything as simple as a mascot standing unmoving in a theme park without getting the simple answer, "It was probably just an empty costume left out. It was probably a mascot on break. I was probably just dreaming it." Seems it's easy to believe the simple solution than to humour the terrifying one. I stayed alert for the rest of the trip, pretending to enjoy the place around my friends and the parents, and keeping a low profile while alone. It felt like an eternity, but I made it home in one piece. I wanted to say things calmed down from here, but they didn't. It got worse. The mascot that haunted my childhood seemingly stopped bothering to hide. I would catch it just standing out in the open, taunting me with its presence. When my parents drove me to school, I would catch glimpses of Mickey's facing the direction of the car between alleys. While out shopping, it'd be standing behind a moving crowd, slowly holding out its hand before fading away behind the hustle. I distinctly remember one instance in my mum's office building. It was some learning experience week at school, and I had decided to work as a runner for my mum's office for a week. The elevators there had those narrow porthole windows to view each floor as you pass, while with others they functioned exactly as intended. However, in the brief instance I was alone, I saw snapshots of Mickey's flashing by each floor. I freaked out at this, terrified for my life, dreading the time in which the elevator would stop. The worst was at night. If I forgot to close my curtains, I would see that horrifically sized head just staring at me through the window. I couldn't call someone. Why bother? It just slip away as soon as they came. Trying to take a picture ended with the same result. A running motif over time was his hand. I would sometimes see him either raising it palm side up, or it would already be held out, almost as if it wanted something. It didn't take me long to think of the solution. The figurine. I frantically rummaged through my old childhood items, toys, books and the like. Nothing Disney, of course. I got rid of everything as a child when I was terrified for my life. I no doubt had got rid of the figurine. I was mortified at this thought. The next idea was a simple one. While at the school library, I googled the exchange rate for the euros for the year I went to Disney and scraped up my pocket money. I had the right amount, so I did something any other kid would think is crazy. I left it out on my doorstep. I know that anyone could take it, but if it was gone in the morning, I'd at least have some hope that it would appease this nightmare. I left the notes on the doorstep under a note apologising for what I did. I placed a small rock on it to keep it from blowing away. And I went to bed. That night I did something that terrified me as a kid. I slept with the curtains open. I wanted to wait until it was late and see if that horrific icon would be staring at me. I woke up in the dark hours of the morning. I took a few deep breaths of courage, closed my eyes with a quick prayer, and spun around to check. Nothing. Was it over? Had I managed to end years of torment? I walked over to my window to see if there was any sign of the thing, gaining steady confidence with each step. I was excited. Excited to live a life without flinching at every possible hiding spot. Excited to leave the house confidently. Excited to have my independence back. This all ended when I stared into my garden. There it was. Standing. Staring as it did in my second trip to Disneyland. I stared back. Not only in horror, but sadness. Sadness that my newfound confidence and excitement was crushed so quickly. As I looked on, it raised its hand. And that's when I realized something. Maybe it's not holding its hand out for the item back. Or any kind of repayment. Maybe it's holding its hand out for me. I know this sounds insane, but I may take it up. Maybe it wants to tell me something or even show me something. Whatever the case, I needed all this down before I went. If this ends here, presume the worst.